Well, we both set off to watch the film Expelled, No Intelligence Allowed, in the Mall of America in Minneapolis. You very kindly were taking me along with a lot of other people as your guest. We had an entertaining time in our different ways. So tell me about it from your point of view.
Right. So I arranged these seats. This was done on the web through the mechanism that the people at Expelled provided. I gave my name. I told them we were going to bring some guests. They sent confirmation emails. Everything was looking good.
So, okay, the story that you were a gatecrasher then is complete and utter nonsense.
Oh, no, not at all. That's absolutely absurd. I mean, if I was a gatecrasher, then just about everybody there was a gatecrasher because they were all doing the same sort of thing.
The same way.
Yes.
Okay.
So we get there and we're standing in line and we're just having a pleasant conversation. I walked up to the front desk to get the little forms that we had to sign. We had to sign these standard forms that said that we wouldn't tape anything. There was a $250,000 fine, et cetera, if we were caught taping. So I got those forms, brought them back and signed them. And as I was coming back, I was pulled aside by a security guard who said that the producer had said that I was supposed to leave the theater immediately. And I asked him why, and he said, we do not have to give an explanation for why. You just have to leave right now. So it was rather intimidating, but I said, sure, okay, I wasn't going to cause any trouble. And I went back and talked to my family for a little bit to explain the situation to them. And then a moment later, the same security guard and a theater manager came up and they said, you have to leave the theater right away. Get out. So I left. And the amusing thing is that they were throwing me out, but they didn't notice that you were standing right there, too.
So I got in.
You got in. My wife got in. My daughter got in. Her boyfriend got in.
Yeah, everybody else got in. What astonishes me about this is, well, everybody's been pointing it out around the blogs, that it's an incredible piece of inept public relations to expel somebody, not just from any film, but from a film about expelling people for their, I don't know, opinions or what they say.
Film in which I am present.
And a film in which you are present and acknowledged and thanked in the acknowledgements at the end of the film for being present.
Yeah.
I would not have believed anybody capable of such utterly inept public relations. And when I actually got into the film and started seeing it, the same individual showed himself to be completely inept as a filmmaker. And I'm not a professional filmmaker myself, but I've had a lot to do with making documentaries. And this was a very, very shoddy, poor, inartistic piece of work.
Right.
There's one of the rules in making a documentary is that you don't have to, every time you mention a word, you don't promptly cut to a picture which illustrates that word. I mean, that it's called the Lord Privy Seal effect because, I don't know, but Lord Privy Seal is an antiquated title in Britain, the Lord Privy Seal.
Uh-huh.
And the sort of film school joke is that when the Lord Privy Seal is mentioned, you have a picture of a lord sitting on a privy with a seal barking by his side. I mean, that's essentially what this man Matheson, who's the producer, did. He was doing Lord Privy Seals all over the place. But it was worse than just artless. It was also quite sinister because the Lord Privy Seals he was delivering were things like guillotines, firing squads, scenes of violence, and above all, scenes from Nazi death camps, etc. So it was a bad film in every possible way. It was also extremely boring.
Uh-huh.
And I
got to tell you, though, that my wife saw it and she said, I was lovely in it.
Well, you were, actually.
It's just the rest that was surrounding it that apparently was very bad.
You were genial and very, very nice looking and gentle, in fact. I don't know what they were afraid of to buy you. I mean, goodness knows they must be insecure, to say the least. That your scenes were good. There were one or two other good bits. I mean, but by far the best scene was when they had a film of the interior of a cell and how it works, which was a really beautiful piece of work. And I couldn't help feeling this cannot be their own work because it was too good. Now, don't you know something about that? Because I didn't know where that film comes from.
Yes, there's a multimedia group working with Harvard. It's called Ex Vivo, and they've got this really spectacular series of video films that you can actually view on the web. I think it's at a Harvard multimedia site. If you just search for Harvard multimedia, I think you can find it. And you'll find that little movie, which is showing, it's showing part of the immune system interacting with other tissues. And it's showing the internal mechanisms of the cell. It is a very pretty movie. And it's got this nice little theme music going along with it.
And is there a commentary?
There is a commentary on the Harvard site. Mm-hmm. Was there a commentary with this one?
Well, yes. It was a creationist commentary.
That's interesting because there's commentary provided by this multimedia group that is technical. It's describing what's going on inside the cell, and it's certainly not any kind of creationist nonsense.
No.
So they've taken the video and they've overdubbed.
I mean, I find it hard to believe that the Harvard group would have given them permission to do that. And if so, I wonder whether, if they did give permission, they did it under a false understanding, because certainly I, and I think you, were deceived into taking part in this film. We were given a very different impression of what the film was going to be about. And so maybe the Harvard people were also lied to in the same way.
Well, this has actually been going around for a little while, that William Dembski apparently was giving talks around the country where he was using this same video clip. And I don't know if it was the same creationist.
Dembski, a notorious creationist.
Yes. Yes, and so he was doing the same thing, and people caught him on this and reported him to Harvard, and he has since apparently made a sort of apology for having done this and has promised not to do it anymore.
Okay.
But here we see an interesting connection. This film is using the same footage. It's kind of curious.
Well, somebody ought to tell the Harvard people that this is going on.
I've passed the word along.
Okay,
we'll
see
what happens.
Yeah. Anyway, after the film, which seemed to go on forever, Mathis went up onto the stage and took questions. It was a very sycophantic crowd. It was, you know, they sort of were obviously entirely supportive of his line. I stood up and asked him point blank why, since this was a film about expelling people and free speech and things like that, freedom of thought, etc., why he expelled somebody who, and I actually mentioned that you, since you were in the film and were thanked, and he more or less called you a gatecrasher because you didn't. I mean, one of the Christian blogs, that I don't know whether you've seen it, is actually saying that both you and I were gatecrashers because we didn't have tickets. That's why I wanted to establish earlier that actually nobody had a ticket. It wasn't a ticketed affair. Anybody could go on the web and reserve a place. Wasn't that what?
That's correct.
And reserve a place for themselves and guests.
There was nothing secretive about it, nothing that was hidden away. Nothing that you didn't need a password. Anybody could have done this. And apparently there are still showings that are going on around the country where you can still do this. You can still reserve seats. And, you know, I've sort of instructed lots of people, go sign up for them.
Yes.
There's actually, on my blog, several commenters have mentioned they've got a little movement going. They're going to sign up PZ Myers for every single show.
Well, it's a spectacular own goal, a spectacular piece of foot shooting, shooting myself in the foot, that simply compounds the poor artistic quality of the film itself. These people are second rate in filmmaking as well as in public relations.
Yes, I think you're elevating them a little bit. Second rate seems a little high.
Yeah.
Third, fourth.
Yeah.